बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम रब्बिश्राहली सदरी वयस्सिरली अम्री वाहलुल उक़दतम मिन लिसानी यफ़क़हू क़ौली। अस्सलामु अलैकुम लिटिल किड्स, दिस इज शहरोज़ अब्दुल्ला एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस व्हाट इज टेंशन इन द स्ट्रिंग, व्हाट इज एटवर्ड मशीन, व्हाट इज मॉडिफाइड एटवर्ड मशीन, व्हाट इज यूनिफॉर्म सर्कुलर मोशन, नॉन यूनिफॉर्म सर्कुलर मोशन एंड व्हाट इज सेंट्रीपेटल फोर्स, सेंट्रीपेटल एक्सेलरेशन, सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स, सेंट्रीफ्यूगल एक्सेलरेशन, व्हाट आर द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ सेंट्रीपेटल फोर्स, राइट। So let me recall previous work, what we have done in the previous work. In the previous lecture we have discussed with friction, causes of friction, microscopic approach of friction, we have discussed types of friction, we have discussed mathematical approach of those friction, graphical interpretation, advantages of friction, disadvantages and methods of removing friction, right. So this was all about today. In yesterday's work we have already discussed, right. Now today we will take start with what is tension in the string. Look, tension is a kind of a force in physics. Tension is a kind of a force, okay. In it's a kind of a force which acts in a string, right. Okay, the force acting along the string is known as tension in the string. Okay, we can also define it like this: the force exerted through a string in upward direction when something is tied to its one end, suspended from it, that is known as tension. For example, we have a kind of a support like this, and we have tied a body of mass m over here. The weight is vertically downward. This is action force. The reaction force over here in the string will be upward. That will be termed as tension in the string. That is represented by capital T. Okay, so when the string is at rest, so T is equal to W, means tension will be equal to W. So we know that W is equal to mg, so T will be equal to mg, right. Now we are going to take start what is Atwood machine. We can discuss connected bodies as well. You know, there are two things, there are two cases actually. In the first case we discuss both the bodies moving vertically, so that is basically termed as Atwood machine. Okay, over here we discuss the first case in which two bodies are moving vertically. Look, we have two bodies of masses m1 and m2, both are tied to the strings and passed over a pulley, right. Over here the body of mass m is like over here, and its weight is W is equal to mg, okay, and the tension is upward over there, while on body B the weight is downward and tension is upward. Over here if we see m1 is greater than m2, mean m1 is moving downward while m2 is moving upward, okay. So there must be some acceleration produced over there, okay. So for body A there are two forces acting. The first is W1, what we call weight, that is equal to mg, and second is tension in the string. So we can write the expression, since W1, yeah, body A is moving downward, so we will write the expression F1 is equal to W1 minus T. Instead of F1 we will write M1A, instead of W1 we will write M1G, and T will be as it is, okay. What we do then, we shift this minus T on the left side while M1A on the right side. So we get the equation T is equal to M1G minus M1A. Say this is your equation number one. Okay, now we coming towards step number two. Okay, for similarly we do the same activity for body B as well. There are two forces acting on body B. The first is weight, that is W2 is equal to M2G, and second is tension in the string, which is vertically upward, right. Okay, since body 2, yeah, W2 moving upwards, so we will write the expression F2 is equal to T minus W2. Instead of this F2, we will write M2A, and T will be as it is. Instead of W2, we will write M2G. Okay, now by shifting, we get T is equal to M2A plus M2G. That is your equation number 2. Okay, what do we do then? Okay, look, comparing the equation 1 and equation 2, this is our step number 3. In step number 3 we compare both the equations. In both the equations left sides are T, definitely right sides will be always equal to, if left sides are equal, definitely the right sides must be equal. So we write m1g minus m1a is equal to m2a plus m2g, and then m1g minus m2g is equal to m1a plus m2a. We have just classified A's into one side, G's into one side, right. On the left side G is common in both, so we will write M1 minus M2 into G, and on right side A is common, so m1 plus m2 is equal to a. Dividing both hand sides like by m1 plus m2, we get a is equal to m1 minus m2 divided by m1 plus m2 multiplied by g. This is the value of what acceleration produced in the setup. Okay, now we discuss elevators and Atwood machine. This is also termed as modified Atwood machine. Okay, what we discuss in elevators and Atwood machine, you know, in elevators case, what we call this is an elevator cage, this is a counterweight. Okay, now over here also we have some weight downward and tension upward. T is upward. Okay, so what we do to find the value of tension, what we do, put the value of A in equation number 2. You can put the same in equation number 1 also. In book they have put in 1, but we put it in equation number 2. From both the equations we get the same result, right? You can see the book. Okay, T is equal to m2 bracket m1 minus m2 divided by m1 plus m2 into g plus m2 g. Okay, now what we do, we take m2g common from both the terms, so we will get t is equal to m2g. Inside we are going to get m1 minus m2 divided by m1 plus m2 plus 1. Now what we do, we take LCM over here. After taking LCM, we are going to get t is equal to m2g into m1 minus m2 plus m1 plus m2 divided by m1 plus m2 over here. Minus m2 will be finished with plus m2. Okay, the remaining equation will be equal to t is equal to m2g into 2m1 divided by m1 plus m2. Now finally we can write that t is equal to 2m1 m2 g divided by m1 plus m2, which is the required equation for tension in the string, right? Okay, now we discuss some short topics over here. The first is uniform circular motion. You know, if a body is moving in circular path and during circular motion the speed of the body is uniform or fixed, so that is what we call uniform circular motion. You must have observed a famous absorbent right and Ferris wheel. Okay, okay, then next, coming towards non-uniform circular motion, when the speed of a body is not constant or not fixed or it's changing during circular motion, so we call it non-uniform circular motion, right? Then we come towards what is centripetal. Now we are going to discuss centripetal force, the force which compels the body to move in a circular path, known as centripetal force. This is also known as center seeking force. Its direction is always towards the center. It is represented by FC. The mathematical formula is FC is equal to mv square by r. FC is equal to mv square by r. Okay, now we discuss centripetal acceleration, the acceleration produced due to centripetal force, known as centripetal acceleration. So mathematically we can write that AC is equal to v square by r. Direction is always towards center, means direction of centripetal acceleration is always in the direction of centripetal force. Okay, centripetal. Then we discuss centrifugal force. Centrifugal force is that force which wants to bring the body away from the circular motion, known as what? Centrifugal force. The force which takes the body away from circular motion, known as centrifugal force, right? It is represented by Fg. Mathematically, it can be written as Fg is equal to minus V square by R. And it is always in opposite direction to centripetal force, right? Okay, then we discuss centrifugal acceleration. So we write the acceleration produced due to centrifugal force, known as centrifugal acceleration. So we can represent it by Ag, and mathematically it can be given as Ag is equal to minus V square by R. Okay, direction is always towards in the direction of what? Centrifugal force. Okay, next we discuss applications of centripetal force. There are so many applications of centripetal force. The first is banking of force, second is centrifuge, third is separator, the fourth is washing machine dryer. Look what is happening in banking of fluid. You must have seen that whenever there is a turn, so the edges are slightly up. Why? To increase the friction. You know what is happening over there? The friction between tire and the ground provides centripetal force to the moving objects or cars to move properly. If the road is slippery by using oil, or if the tire is old, so what happened over there? The friction is reduced over there. When the friction is reduced, the car is unable to move properly. So over here, the accident may happens to avoid such kind of activity. The edges of the turning points are slightly up. Okay, next is centrifuge. You know, centrifuge, a kind of a instrument which is used to separate different samples and different components of the samples. you know, it is moved very high speed. So the component in a liquid are separated. Okay, the lighter one comes at the center, the heavier one comes at the edges, so they can be separated very easily. Separator is a kind of a centrifuge which is used to separate the milk component. You know, inside milk we have milk also, cream also. The you know what happened over here, we give a very high speed to the milk, so we know that the heavier or denser particle moves at the edge, while the lighter particles comes at the center, so they can be separated very easily. Okay, then we have washing machine dryers. In washing machine dryers, the same phenomena is taking place. You know, the edges are having some holes over there. When the cloths are moving in circular path over there, so what happens, the water comes out of that holes and inside we get a dry cloth. So this was the end of chapter number 3, dynamics, class 9 physics. This was end. We have done with the theory of all the chapter number 3, dynamics. Done. Okay, let me recall the today's work, what we have done today. In today's lecture we have discussed tension in the string, we have discussed Atwood machine, we have discussed alleviators in Atwood machine, right? We have discussed a proper detailed derivation of it. We have discussed uniform circular motion, non-uniform circular motion, centripetal force, centripetal acceleration, centrifugal force, centrifugal acceleration, and different applications of centripetal force with details like banking of rods, centrifuge, separators, washing machine, dryers. All these things we have done. So this was all about today's lecture. Hope you have enjoyed the lecture. Thanks for watching. Allah Hafiz. Fi Amanillah.